Good morning, Chief. Oh, boy. Here. Here's your coffee. Look, I'll have your juice and your eggs ready in any second. I overslept. You know, I set the alarm. I don't know how I could oversleep like this. I go to bed early. I try to be a good girl. I just don't understand.
Juice, no, I overslept.
Don't come in here with all your milk. You got to have more than juice.
No, I don't have time for any more juice.
Shut up and have some
exam. Overslept.
Women. Always late.
Excuse me. Always late, I might as well go back to sleep.
Sure. Get a head start on being late tomorrow.
Daddy, I don't think you should deal in reckless generalities about women.
We didn't oversleep because we are women. We overslept because our man-made alarms did not go off.
Look, I gotta go. Hang in there, Nell, okay?
Wait, come back here. Get your breakfast. Here.
Nell, don't let Daddy get away with any of his archaic, bourgeois, male-oriented chauvinist
stereotypes. Honey, shut up and go to school, please.
Give him hell, Nell.
Samantha!
Sorry. Give him heck, Nell. Then give him hell.
You forgot your breakfast!
Peace, Nell. I don't want to argue with you. And I do respect your point of view.
That's very nice of you, Chief.
Besides, you can't win with women anyway. It's human nature now. Women have trouble getting out of bed in the morning, and men don't.
I'm surprised women get out of bed at all if they have to listen to a man like you talk.
See? What did I tell you? If I... I've said it once, I've said it a million times. You can't win with women.
Please stop me from talking.
Only reason that he's awake to listen to you is because he's a man.
Joey, you're gonna be late for school.
No, he won't. Pop got up an hour ago and took your man-child to school.
And I suppose you think that proves something.
Only that that's the way men are. We're always punctual. Why can't a woman be more like a man? I get up every morning at 6 o'clock, come downstairs at exactly 7:15, and get the morning paper. Except for today. Paper hasn't come yet. Probably because Nancy, our paper girl, overslept again. Don't you ever knock, Simpson?
Sorry, Chief.
Officer Dwyer out there yet?
Uh-uh. What kind of sandwich you want for lunch today, Chief?
Ham on rye.
Ham on rye. You want cheese on that?
If I wanted cheese, I would have said ham and cheese.
Hold the cheese. Kind of bread you want that on, Chief?
Rye.
hold the white meat.
Oh, please, Simpson. I got enough problems to deal with today.
What's the matter, Chief?
Officer Dwyer, she's asked for a promotion. And I don't know how to handle it.
Why don't you just tell her what you told me when I asked for a promotion?
What did I tell you?
Get out.
Yeah, but she might cry.
I cry?
Get out!
That was white bread, wasn't it, Chief? You're in luck. He's in a good mood.
I got your note, Chief.
Come on in, Cryer. Dwyer. Just let me close this door. Well, would you like a coffee?
I'd like to talk about my promotion.
Beer. Right. I'm just not sure you're... How can I put this?
Qualified?
Oh, no, no. I know you're qualified. You have an impeccable record. No absences in 5 years, 10 letters of commendation.
So, I get assigned to a squad car, right?
You're some kind of cop, Dwyer. Your record says you type 85 words a minute.
I also got 49 out of 50 on the pistol range.
Well, keep practicing.
Do I get this promotion or not?
Look, why don't we give it a few months, huh? I mean, you're a woman. And I think it's too dangerous for you right now out there.
I can see now that you still think the man should hunt and the woman should stay in the cave and type.
I like that. I like it better than keeping barefoot and pregnant. I'm just kidding.
I don't think it's funny.
Oh, now, now. Listen, Alice, please don't cry.
Cry? You think because I'm a woman, I'm gonna cry?
Oh, you're all the same. You never can win with a woman.
And you can't win with a man who hasn't had a progressive thought since he stepped out of the cave. I quit.
Dwyer, pull yourself together. Please.
If I were a man, you wouldn't have done this. Now I know why you wanted to see me alone.
Well, at least she didn't cry.
Joey, upstairs.
Aw, do I have to?
Yes.
Aw.
What's this all about, Nell?
Annie, why don't you tell them?
Well, I came over because my organization, the Congress of Determined Women, has a legal fund to help women who are victims of sexual harassment.
The sooner this day is over, the happier I'll be. I should have overslept this morning like the rest of you. I go into the station house, ready to face the day, walk into my office, and suddenly I'm hit with a bolt right out of the blue.
Chief, we were just about to discuss the Congress of Determined Women and a sexual harassment case that was filed this morning.
I don't want to hear anything about women. It was a woman put the frosting on my day.
Listen,
Officer Dwyer. Officer Dwyer comes into my office. She goes berserk because I won't give her a promotion.
Look,
and that was before I took my coat off.
Chief, Officer Dwyer is suing you for sexual harassment.
You couldn't wait till I took my coat off? How How could she do such a thing? Sexual harassment? Me?
Girls, why don't you just go in the kitchen for a while, all right?
Okay. Did you really do it, Dad?
Samantha, what a terrible thing to say to your father. Of course he didn't do it. Get in the kitchen. You didn't do it, did you, Chief?
Of course I didn't do it.
Didn't do what?
Oh, come here. I want you to go in the kitchen.
How am I going to learn anything?
I'm going to count to three.
I know how to count to three.
Joey, please, into the kitchen.
Chief, look, I don't want you to be too upset about this.
Yeah, Chief, listen to Addie. She knows.
You see, the CDW will review Officer Dwyer's complaint and make an evaluation as to whether or not to give her the funds to press legal action against you.
Oh, I get it. They usually find the woman is exaggerating. There's no lawsuit, so she drops the charges.
Never.
Don't listen to Addie. She doesn't know what she's talking about.
Well, you tell your counselor whatever it is that Carl Kaniski has a wonderful reputation as a champion of women's causes. And I'm not going to have it screwed up by some dumb broad.
We do not use that word anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that. I just get excited when I'm attacked by some daffy women's organization like that. You know, helps out any dizzy brunette who's trying to get ahead.
Uh-huh. Well, this dizzy brunette is leaving before she gets arrested for assault and battery.
What's with her?
She's one of those daffy, dizzy women that you just can't win with.
Well, I don't care what she thinks about me. All I care is what the kids think.
I wouldn't worry. You know, they think the world of you.
I can't believe it. My father's a lech.
What's a lech? Well, I don't think he did it. Did what?
Even if he did, I'll bet she started it.
Started what?
Yeah, you're right. It's just not like Daddy.
What isn't?
Joey, will you get out of here?
This woman is taking you to court.
Why is she taking you to court?
Joey, come here. I want you to go upstairs.
Nobody wants me in the kitchen. Nobody wants me in the living room. Hey, that's okay with me. But I'd sure like to know what a lech is.
Where the hell did he hear that?
Probably from television. That's where I learn everything.
Hiya, Nell. Get out of my way. I'm furious. And when I'm furious, you better get out of my way.
Take your hat off. You're in the house.
Well, I'm sorry, Nell.
What is it, Simpson?
The knife of that officer, Dwyer. She has the gall to ask me to be her witness.
Why would she ask you to be her witness?
Because I saw everything.
I didn't think things could get any worse. My entire life is in Simpson's hands.
Don't worry, Chief. I'm gonna swear there's no finer law officer in the land. Every morning he gives us a pep talk. Then when he sends us out in the streets, he says, go get him, and gives each one of us a pat on the fanny. Oh. Just like Sparky Anderson.
Simpson, when we go to court, maybe you should leave off that last part.
Oh, no. Everybody loves Sparky.
Simpson. Goodbye.
Oh, okay. I just wanted you to know that I'm gonna be rough on Officer Dwyer, Chief. She's got it coming. The way she parades around the station house in that tight uniform. If you hadn't groped her, Chief, somebody else would.
Chief?
Chief, are we in big trouble here?
Oh, come on, Nell.
Just exactly what did Simpson see?
All he saw was Officer Dwyer with her blouse ripped and my hand on her chest.
That's all?
I've heard of cupping a field, but feeling a cop?
It was all her fault. She ripped her badge off and tore her blouse. When I went to calm her down, I that's when the physical contact took place.
And the grope?
Pop, I didn't grope her. God, this is so stupid. It was an accident. Simpson wouldn't have seen anything if he'd knocked.
The door was closed?
Well, I thought she'd want some privacy. I knew it was gonna be a ticklish situation.
You tickled her, too?
I didn't tickle her anything.
Carl, looks to me as if Officer Dwyer was a mighty pretty woman, huh?
How do I know if she's pretty or not? She's a cop. All cops look alike to me.
Would you say she's as pretty as Simpson?
All right, maybe she is attractive.
Carl, it's a delicate question, but did you ever touch her at any other time when she was in your office?
Of course not. Well, maybe just once.
A little Sparky Anderson?
No! I put my hands on her shoulders when I thought she was gonna cry. But it was like I was her father.
Carl, remember, you're a widower. Widowers can often get very, very lonely.
Well, what is that supposed to mean, Pop? You're a widower yourself.
Where do you think I was till 2 this morning?
It looks as though my own family thinks I'm guilty. The only reason that this whole thing happened is she wants to get even with me for not reassigning her. She should have known that I'd never send a woman that pretty out on the streets.
Chief, look, we trust you. And we know that you didn't mean to do it.
Thanks, Nell.
But you know, sometimes, subconsciously, we are attracted to other people. Do you think maybe that's what happened to you in your office?
I don't know. Come. What are you doing here?
Well, you know, you ran off this morning. I forgot your wallet.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
I knew I forgot something.
Uh-huh. Well, you also forgot your badge. And your gun. And... your shoes. You went off in your sneakers.
I'll be damned.
Well, you got a lot on your mind. You're upset.
Yeah.
I'm upset, too.
Is that why you're wearing your sneakers? Come.
I'm sorry, I'll come back later.
No, no, I was just about to leave.
No, you're not. Any communication between Officer Dwyer and myself is gonna take place in front of a witness.
Oh, so you're Officer... Well, I'm Nell Hopper.
I know. Simpson's told me all about
you. Well, let me just tell you a few things, Officer Dwyer, about this man. This man happens to be a wonderful father.
I know, I know.
He mows the lawn every weekend. He is also the captain of the bowling team.
Hold on.
I knew his wife before she died.
I came by to tell you, Chief, that I just went by the CDW and dropped my complaint. This morning, I realized that you're not the kind of man who would be guilty of sexual harassment.
Oh, thank heavens. See, you word for nothing.
Well, I'm glad you finally came to your senses.
See, last night, I dreamed that I was in a barn, and this wild, passionate man threw me down in the hay and started ripping my clothes off. I looked up at his face. It was you. And I woke up laughing.
The chief in the hay, making hay. What the heck?
Just kidding. Really, chief, it's not that I don't think of you as a wild.
I'm so ashamed. I owe you an apology for today and yesterday.
Well, look, I kind of provoked you by laughing at you.
Yeah, but I wouldn't have done that to one of my men. The truth is, well, I didn't know it, but I guess I think you're a good-looking lady. But that's no excuse for what I did yesterday.
I accept your apology, Chief. And I'd like to stay on the force, but just as one of the guys.
Well, now that you are a liberated male, how about putting this guy in a squad car where she belongs?
Okay, okay. You just can't win with you women.
Thanks, Chief. And I promise you, I'll be the best cop you've got out there.
And I'm gonna treat you just like I treat every other cop, Dwyer. Officer Jackson's your partner. Go change your uniform and draw your equipment.
Yes, sir.
Go get him, Dwyer.
Stop!